All right, here's another rate times time equals distance problem. Uniform motion. So we have a 555-mile trip. So that's why this whole distance in my picture is 555 miles, and we know it's 5 hours. But the car was driven at T speed. So the first part of the trip, it was going 105 miles per hour, and the second part of the trip, it was going 115 miles per hour. So we want to do a little chart. So let's just talk about the first and the second part of the trip. There's a rate for the first part, a time for the first part, and a distance, and the same thing for the second part of the trip. All right, on the first part, I'm told that it's 105 miles per hour. And on the second part, it was 115. All right, now the tricky part. It was 5 hours total. So they didn't each, it wasn't 5 hours for each. It might be 3 and 2, 1 and 4, 1.5 and 3.5. That's what we don't know. But the time must add up to 5. So if you're doing this with a single variable, and you can also do this with two variables if you know how to solve equations with two variables, but if you're doing it with a single variable, if the first part is x, and the time has to add up to 5. So x plus what is going to give you 5? Actually, it's 5 minus x. See what happens if you put 5 minus x? Whatever x is, let's say it was 2, you'd have to subtract that from 5 to get the 3 hours left here, whatever it might be. Also, you can see if you add, the x's cancel. X plus 5 minus x does add up to 5 hours total. So we have x and 5 minus x. It doesn't matter where you put the x and where you put the 5 minus x, but once you define it, you have to stick with it. So now, what's the distance for the first part? I have to do rate times time, which is 105x, and the second will be 115 times 5 minus x. All right, so now I go back up to the picture. All right, so in this first part, I've got 105x, and in the second part, let's see, if I do the distributive property, that's 575 minus 115x. So from the picture, this piece, right, that distance plus the second distance here has to add up to 555. So that's the formula, I'm sorry, that's the equation we're going to write. 105x plus 575 minus 115x equals 555. Okay. So on the left-hand side, I have 105 minus 115. That's going to be negative 10x. And then I have to subtract 575 from both sides. So that's going to be negative 20. Now when you divide by negative 10, you get x equals 2. All right, not done. So now I need to go back and check it by putting it in a chart. First and second part, the rate is still 105 and 115. Now, the time, I now know x, so it's 2. So if you went 2 hours for the first half, there's 3 left for the other half, which of course is 5 minus 2. And the distance here, you multiply rate times time equals distance, that's 210. And this is 345. And does that make sense with a picture? 210 and 345. Does that add up to a total of 555 miles? That's David in the problem? Yes. Okay, so now the question. How long did the car drive at each speed? Okay, now I've got all our information right here. The car drove 105 miles per hour for 2 hours and at 115 miles per hour for 3 hours. Isn't this fun? So notice it. Give yourself plenty of space to write this out, to check it, make sure it all makes sense. You can see in this check chart here, you've got the correct rate, the time really adds up to 5 hours, the distance really adds up to 555 miles, etc.